This Discord post by one of the game's developers, Gribbly, celebrated the capacity test party, a quickly thrown together tech test to determine how many people they could reliably have in a single instance. This paved the way for the modern player limit in an instance to be 40, which is the maximum, right? You would be wrong. At the peak of this event, they were able to have 54 people in a single instance. In modern day Rec Room, 40 players is the soft cap to prevent users on lower end platforms from lagging too much or crashing the game outright. Stay tuned because not only do we go over the full history of this forgotten event, but we attempt to break the record ourselves to see if we can have 55 or more users in a single instance. This is the Capacity Test Party. First, we must go back in time. Our story begins in Rec Room's early years, back before there was a focus on UGC. Many of today's activities did not exist, and the game was VR only. The year is 2017, and Against Gravity was creating one of the finest VR social spaces around. Our story begins in the Rec Room Discord, the Against Gravity Discord.
Hey all, we could use some help with the test this afternoon. 4 PM Pacific time, there will be a featured event, which is a capacity test. We want to see what happens if we put 50 people in the lounge. This is purely a tech test, there's not actually a proper event. Okay, but please remove the mic.
Not recording that one again. Gribbly put this announcement out on Discord, as well as the Rec Room subreddit. Back in the day, there wasn't a proper event system. In the 2017 Rec Center, there was a door in the middle called the featured event door. That was the event system. The developers would then use dev magic to point the door towards any particular instance currently running based on if they were hosting an event, or they were helping out a community member gain attendance to their event. The event was held as stated at 4 PM. And unfortunately, not a whole lot of media from the event exists. We do have a couple of screenshots, some posted on Discord by the devs, and one shared on Reddit. What I was able to gather from secondhand accounts from some of the devs is that they were able to fill the room to around 54 users. This was the lounge too, which is not the biggest space in the game. Why not host the event somewhere else? The park didn't exist, and the performance hall wasn't yet in the game as a room separate from 3D charades. Therefore, the only suitable room was the lounge. The event ends, and the devs thank the community for coming to help out. They use their findings. They don't really use their findings for a while. The first 40 player room wouldn't exist until the creation of the performance hall, which would allow users to set the room limit to 40, using the limited room settings that existed at the time. And then the community moved on. I never hear anyone talk about this event or that it existed. But let's be honest, a lot of the players at the time have left long ago. Likely during Rec Room's more transformative years when it dropped the VR-only focus. However, the event took place and there was a record set. 54 users. Can we beat it in modern-day Rec Room?
RecCon is confirmed to only have official RecCon events created by Rec Room employees.
It looks like this year all the events are organized, so they're all with verified creators or verified influencers.
RecCon 2023 was coming up with some slightly unpopular changes. Users would not be able to host their own official panels, with all official panels being organized by Rec Room themselves. This was a disappointment to many, including Squirrelador and Burachi. You see, they hosted their RecCon After Party event as an official RecCon event every year, tracing back to the first RecCon in 2020. I was a big fan of their after parties, so when I heard the news that user events were not being premiered officially, and then seeing Squirrelador's post somewhere that the event wasn't happening this year, I stepped in and tried to see what I could do. Editing start. This decision was partially reversed later by still allowing users to host events tagged as RecCon within the game. But they wouldn't be deemed officially part of RecCon, so they couldn't be viewed in the convention room itself. Yeah, it was kind of weird. Moving on. At the time of the event, I worked at Rec Room, so I was able to easily reach the event coordinator and ask them if we can still host the after party, and I would just be in charge of making sure it went well, since I would be representing it officially. To my surprise, they get back to me a couple hours later with yes. I relay the news to Squirrelador, who then lets Borachi know. They start getting to work revamping their old party room, TwoSoothingBlues, and redesigning it using Rec Room Studio, which lets you use Unity to help build and polish Rec Room UGC rooms. RecCon is here. We have free after parties on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, respectively. I attend the Friday party, and it was a lot of fun. I skipped the Saturday party, but still pop in to help start the event and ensure everything was smooth sailing. Sunday rolls in, and I was planning on making it to the after party, as it not only it was the final after party, but it was the final event that would wrap up RecCon 2023. And that's when I think, hey, wouldn't it be funny if we could get as many people in an instance as possible? 2 hours before the event, I message a couple of people about the idea, most notably M. White and Nona and Tidal Wavy. They have a huge network of friends within Rec Room, and I thought they'd be the best chance to try and overfill an instance. Here's the plan. They could gather a large crowd in a pre-party room. I would then use a mic to broadcast to them my intention, and once the event started, we'd load up in a 40-player private instance of the after-party room. From there, I would use my magic dev powers bestowed upon me to push users into the instance who requested an invite either via Discord or via the in-game messaging system. The event starts, and it's not very easy to fill up the instance. In the beginning of the event, the number of players stayed around 50 people. Users would keep crashing, likely due to the frame rate lag, the internet dropping them, or some of them would just crash outright. However, we slowly got to 52 users. No, wait, it's 53 users. 55? We had just broken the record set all the way back in 2017. How high could we go now? We had a lot of interested people asking for an invite back due to lagging out, and more users interested in coming in. I knew we still had some ways to climb. And what do you think the final number was? Roll a clip.
Alright, go. Like we hit 63 people in a single instance in Rec Room. It beats the 54 people in a single instance set in 2017.
That is all from me for now, but if you'd like to watch a video on how Rec Room is improving, click here.